Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can read array from file and how you can write array into a file. Right? So this program will be based on file handling in C, and that will tell you the process of array file handling in C. Before starting, if you go to description of this video, so you will find links of various playlists related to C language video. So you can follow them as well. Now, to explain this process, I will be writing two separate programs. So my first program will be reading array from user and writing it into a file. So that will be first program. So first program will be reading from user and writing into file. And user will be providing all the elements into array, and that array will be stored into file. Second program will be reading array from a file and storing it into another file. So let's say it is file 1. So file 1, file 2. So the input which will be received from user will go into file 1. Then I will be opening file 1 and storing its content into file 2. Right? And all this process will be dependent on how we can read and write array into file. So let's begin with this first program. So first of all, inside main function, I'm going to declare a file pointer, then an integer array. Let's say its size is 10, variable I, so that we can process a loop. Then I am going to open a file. So here you can see we need to write the input which is received from user into this file. So the file 1 should be opened into W. So here I am writing name of file as file1.txt, and I am opening it into W mode. So W mode opens a file in write mode. If file is not available, it will be created automatically. And if file is already there, so its previous contents will be erased automatically. So use this W mode very carefully. If you want to preserve the previous data as well, so instead of using W, you can use A mode, that is for appending contents. And this name, you can use any name, whatever you want. And txt is for notepad, so the editor we all use. So this is name of file and this is mode. Now I'm going to check if fp double equals to null, and if this condition is true, so I'm going to print file not found, and through exit I'm going to terminate this process, right? So you might be thinking why I implemented this if condition, because I am using W mode. If file is not available, it will be created. So why I am checking fp with null? So there is a reason. Let's say your memory is filled completely, your memory is full, there is no space. So in that scenario, if your file is not available, so will new file be created or not? So your answer will be no. So for example, if you are using your mobile phone and your memory is full and you want to click a picture, so will your phone be clicking a picture and saving it into memory? No, it will say you erase some previous picture or erase something from the memory so that new pictures can be clicked and saved. So similarly, if your memory is full, then W mode will not be able to create new files, and your file pointer will be having none. So that's why in every case, if you are using read mode, W mode, A mode, whatever mode you are using, always use this if condition so that you can check whether file pointer is having a particular address or not. So if it is having null, so program will be terminated here. So unnecessarily, the remaining statements will not be executed. Now after this, I can write a printf statement. So it will display a message, enter values, To read these values, I am going to write a for loop which will repeat 10 times. So this for loop will repeat 10 values from user through this scanf. So this is very simple. So I hope if you are watching this video related to file handling, so you are familiar with array also. So you can understand this process. It is very easy, which is reading 10 values and all the values will be stored into array. Now our requirement, this requirement is completed. We have received input from user. Now we need to store that received input into file 1 so that that file 1 can be opened in read mode and that content will be stored into file. And this is the benefit of file handling. If you want to store your data permanently, then only you need file handling concept, otherwise. So whatever I receive from user, now I want to store that permanently into file and that too using array. So I am going to use a predefined function that is fwrite. So fwrite will store your complete array without implementing any loop in a single statement. So here you need to pass name of array, then size of individual location. So our array is of integer type. So here I'm passing size of int. So this size of is also predefined. So it will calculate size of int data type. Then third argument will be number of elements. So this array contains total 10 elements. That's why I'm passing 10 here. If your array is containing more elements, you can change this as well. And lastly, file pointer. So here you can see this file pointer is opening this file 1. So if I am writing fp here, it means this array will be stored into this file 1. And after this, you can write fclose and fp. So this way, I hope you understood how we can read array from user and through a single fwrite statement, how we can write all these elements which are available into a file. So this array will be storing into this file. Each block is having size of int, and this is the quantity that will be stored into this file. So this first process is completed. We successfully received input from user and we stored that array into file with the help of fwrite. Now coming on to second process. So here we need to maintain two files, file 1 and file 2. And file 1 I need to open in read mode and file 2 I need to open in w mode. So now I am going to erase these statements. So I will be modifying the beginning steps and then you will see how I can read the contents of file 1 without any loop, and without any loop those contents will be stored into file 2. So here I need to open two files. So so now I am going to declare two file pointers. So let's say f1 and file pointer f2. Then array is same. This will not be required, variable will not be required. Then this is f1, fopen file1.txt, and this time mode will be read, right? File2, I need to open, and its mode will be w. So when you will be executing previous program that I explained, so that program will create this file1. And after the creation of that file, we can open that in read, right? And this file 2 is open in W mode. So if it is not available, it will be created. But for further movement, we need to check this condition. This time I am checking it for both. If F1 is null, then also it will be true. If F2 is null, then also it will be true. If both are not containing null, then this condition will be false and remaining statements will be executed. So this is very important, because if file is not opened successfully, then there is no need to execute remaining statements. So we can write file not found or file not opened and exit. So this way, I hope you understood the process till here. Now we need to delete array from file 1 and we need to write that into file 2. So only two statements will perform this operation. So if you want to delete array from file, so you can use f read, then a name of array, size of int, comma 10 and f1. So this time f read function will be reading data from f1 and that will be stored into a. So f1 will store your data into a array. Size of int, so we need to receive integer values, and how many elements we are going to receive? 10 elements. So through previous program we stored 10 elements, that's why we are getting 10 elements, and that information will be available into this array. Now we can use fwrite again, and same array will be stored into file 2 using fwrite this way. So here you can see fread is a single statement which is reading whole array from file, and fwrite is also a single statement which is writing whole array into file 2, and file 2 is this, right? So I hope you understood how we can write a data that is received from file 1 into file 2, and that too with the help of array. And then you can write f close all, so that all files, those are opened in your program, will be closed. So this is the process through which I hope you understood how we can read array from file and how we can write array into a file. So I explained you two programs. So implement these programs in your laptop so that you can understand this process well. And if you want to watch more programming related videos, go to description of this video. There you will find lots of playlist links related to C language videos. So do follow them. And thank you for watching this video.